We just finished reading verse 3 that we are blessed with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ. Now, this is very interesting. Don't be Calvinistic. Don't read what is not there, like, you know, the Calvinists that think that, oh, you know, we've been chosen. No. He has chosen practically everyone. Everyone can be saved and blessed and sealed like this, but only those who believe will receive it. Anyway, in verse 4, according as he had chosen us in him. It's no question he chosen me because I'm so special. No. There is a choice of God in Christ. If people get in Christ they get blessed. According as he had chosen us in him before the foundation of the world. Please, I would like to underline this, before the foundation of the world. We read in Genesis 1:1, in the beginning, we can't pinpoint exactly when, God created the heaven and the earth. Well, according to the scripture here, the plan of salvation by grace through faith, the gift of God, has been planned by God when? Before even the creation of the world. Which means, of course, that God knew that his creation, in particular man, would turn against him and become lost in sins and trespasses and go to damnation. But he has prepared a plan of salvation, which was a mystery. That's why we studied the mystery. We preach Jesus Christ according to the revelation of the mystery. The mystery was hidden in God. Now it's been revealed. So don't go around saying, oh, it's a mystery religion. No, mystery means that this will of God was hidden in him before the foundation of the world. But now it's been revealed. But now, okay? According as he had chosen us in him, in Christ, before the foundation of the world, that we should what? Should be holy and without blame before him in love. Oh, now can the people say, you have got to be holy. Like, don't wear the gold watch. For a woman, don't wear makeup. They look at the flesh. They think that you become holy by reforming, cleaning up, better your flesh. But it doesn't work like that. It's God that sets you apart. That's why. Should be holy. He sets you apart. And without blame before him in love. What does it mean? Well, once you're in Christ, you're set apart. You are holy means you're set apart. You are without blame. Why? Because Christ took all the blame. Actually, even more, you know, he took the curse. Christ became a curse for us. He who knew no sin became sin so that we, the sinners, believing, might become the righteousness of God in him. Please give glory to God, okay? Give glory to God. Having predestinated us unto the adoption of children by Jesus Christ to himself, according to the good pleasure of his will. So God, especially for us Gentiles, he could do only one thing. Give us grace and adoption. Why? Because we never had any covenants with God. Israel did. The Old and New Covenant, the Old and New Testament, they are to the nation of Israel of the past and the nation of Israel of the future. We are not, as many people say, New Testament Christians. We are not. The testaments, the covenants, they don't belong to us. They belong to the nation of Israel. And you and I, we are not Israel. Israel's 12 tribes. We don't belong to any tribe. Okay? So, God has adopted us like children by Jesus Christ to himself. And he hasn't done all this thing, you know, first class, second class, third class believers. This is terrible stuff that's going on even among grace believers. Anyone, I want to say anyone, I want to repeat, anyone, including me, including you, who believes and receives this glorious gospel of Christ gets completely saved, sealed, blessed, and adopted as a child by Jesus Christ to himself, to God. We become children of God. This is a tremendous blessing, a tremendous privilege. And in fact, this is to, according to the good pleasure of his will. I wouldn't save myself. You know what I mean? I know how bad I am. You know what I mean? But God is good, is gracious, is merciful. But please, don't play with that. Receive and believe the gospel while you're alive. Because after this life, there is no hope. You choose to believe and receive now. You can't choose afterwards. I don't care what religion says. You know, they pray for the dead, all this terrible stuff. To the praise of the glory of his grace, wherein he has made us accepted in the beloved. I told you there are 120 blessings. I'm reading them. One of these, you and I, ungodly sinners, that we haven't done a good thing worthy to be even looked at by God, the moment we are in Christ, we are accepted in the beloved. Just reverse what religion does. In religion, they say that you have to accept Jesus into your heart. Into your heart. Now, that's an impossibility. Your heart is so tremendously deceived and wicked that Christ wouldn't come and live in it. And don't do this prayer of the sinner's prayer, because God does not even listen to the prayers of the sinners. But the moment you hear the gospel of Christ, that Christ died for your sins, all of them, that's the final solution. You don't try to save yourself anymore. You don't think, okay, he died for the sins that I committed 10 years ago, but now today I got to confess. No, don't. Please, just stay with the word of God where it says, wherein he has made us accepted in the beloved. Who is the beloved? The Lord Jesus Christ. Even in his earthly ministry, when Jesus Christ was baptized in water, which is not to you, because you're not Israel, okay? You are not even Jesus Christ. In the River Jordan by John the Baptist, of all people, they saw the heavens open. They heard the voice of God. They saw the Holy Spirit coming upon Christ like as a dove. It was not a dove. You know, you see people doing the Holy Spirit like a dove. That's ridiculous. Okay, God, you can't represent with an animal like a dove. It's an animal. It's a bird. And people say, oh, because the dove. Just forget it. Don't try to depict Christ, God, the Holy Spirit. You haven't seen him with your own fleshly eyes. Don't do an image. Don't do an image. End of story. So anyway, the voice of God says, this is my beloved son in whom I am well pleased. So praise God, we get accepted in the beloved. And now this verse 7, the beloved in whom, in Christ, in the beloved, we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins, plural, according to the riches of his grace. Please consider this. He didn't forgive you one sin, two sins, or your sins until you believe, and then you got to do, you know, you got to live it. As they say, the lifestyle, you know, you got to walk the straight and narrow. No. It's good you do, but you will fail. Just know that all your sins, this is plural. English, sin is singular, sins is plural. In whom, in Christ, we have redemption. We have been bought back through his blood. The price has been paid is the blood of Jesus Christ, not the water of the baptism tub. The forgiveness of sins. Christ has forgiven us all our sins according to the riches of his grace. I mean, can you just reflect, ponder, consider how great are the riches of his grace? They are so great. They are so great. Thank you, Lord. Verse 8, wherein he has abounded toward us in all wisdom and prudence. I stop here for now and I pick up in the next mini video. Bye.